Hello students, my name is Alpa Rupala, Assistant Professor from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology, Computer Department. Welcome to the lecture series of Mobile Computing and Wireless Communication. Unit number 3, Subtopic DECT. Topics to be covered in this lecture. First of all, we will understand DECT, what is DECT? What is the frequency allocation of DECT? Then after, we will learn the DECT system architecture, and then after, the protocol architecture of DECT. So the full form of DECT is Digitally Enhanced Cordless Telecommunication. Digitally Enhanced Cordless Telecommunication. So the cordless word, cordless means code. The word code means wire. So cordless means wireless system. Any system which is wireless and which is digitally enhanced for telecommunication is known as DECT. Any cordless telephones, if you are having the example, this kind of phones which were previously used, but nowadays we are not using this kind of phone. But this is the one kind of technology which were used in this cordless telephone, that is DECT. Earlier, before 1998, there were another technology which was based on analog cordless phone, were known as CT1 and CT1 plus, that is cordless technology 1 and cordless technology 1 plus. But this two technology was analog based. But we already know that from the analog signal and digital signal, digital communication is very much better. So the whole technology was being converted to the digital one. So then after, DECT was formed. But earlier, the full form of DECT was Digital European Cordless Telephone or Digital European Cordless Telecommunication. Then after, the full form was revised by Digitally Enhanced Cordless Telecommunication. Okay, so this was all about the DECT. Now, this is a kind of protocol. Here is nothing like that you are using this protocol only at a cordless telephone. The intercom communication is also having the same protocol. So if we talk about where we are using this DECT, so mostly it is used in offices or in campus area or in threshold, or you can use that in home. So basically, what is the difference between DECT and GSM? The GSM can cover up to 70 kilometer cell diameter, but the DECT can cover only about 300 meter diameter. So ultimately, you can, by one antenna, you can only cover the 300 meter diameter area. But in GSM, you can cover more diameter. So ultimately, in GSM, you can accommodate more number of users. But whereas in DECT, you cannot accommodate more number of users. Hardly 10,000 users for 300 meter area with the multiplexing can be covered. So, if we talk about the frequency range of DECT, then the frequency range of DECT is from 1880 to 1990 megahertz, which ultimately offers 120 full duplex channels. Okay, and ultimately, likewise in your GSM, GSM is using FDD, FDMA and TDMA. Okay, so ultimately you are having 992 channels for uplink and 992 channels for downlink. Same as you can have 120 full duplex channel. Now, ultimately, it is also using FDMA and TDMA, but in replacement of in GSM FDD, we were dividing our uplink and downlink according to the frequency. But in DECT, we are dividing uplink and downlink fundamental according to time, that is time division duplex. Okay, in the multiplexing topic, I have already told you that we will discuss the TDD in later topic. and the topic is DECT only. Because we are using FDMA, we are using TDMA, and we are dividing uplink and downlink of frequency of TDD using TDD. Okay, uplink and downlink frequency using TDD, that is time division duplex. So ultimately, after applying FDMA and TDMA, we were having the 24 slot. From this 24 slot, 12 slot will be for uplink and 12 slot will be for downlink. So here it is the architecture of DECT. You can see here it is the global network. Likewise, all the network which is being connecting your DECT are all fundamental, and that global network is being connected by the local networks, multiple local networks. Same as your MSC were having HLR and VLR, here your local networks are having HDB and VDB, that is home database and visitor database. So all the information related to your subscriber will be saved in HDB, and roaming related required data, that will be the subset of HDB, will be stored in a VDB. Okay, same as your HLR and VLR, functionality is similar. Now this local network is connecting multiple terminals, and here you are having two type of terminal, fixed terminal and portable terminal. Likewise, in your cordless telephone, one particular device portion was with the wire. So ultimately that portion is connected to your network, but the device which you are using, the receiver, is portable. So ultimately you are having two type of device, portable device and fixed device. Okay, portable device and fixed device. So the fixed device is being connected with your local network, and portable device is you can roam and you can use that device, but that signal is being transmitted according to fixed terminal only. So the range of this portable terminal and fixed terminal should not be extended. Okay, around you can say 10 meter area you can use this particular portable and fixed terminal roaming. After that you cannot use. And for portable terminal using, you can use portable applications. So this was all about the DECT system architecture. Global network is being connected with the local network. Local network is having its own HDB and VDP. All the fixed terminals are connected by your local network. Fixed terminal is transferring data and getting data from the portable terminal. And you can use the portable terminal by the portable application. So this was all about the system architecture. Now next one is DECT protocol architecture. Same like your GSM, you were having three layers. In your GPRS, you were having three layers. In same DECT, you are also having three layers. The layer number one, physical layer. The layer number two, data link layer, which includes medium access control layer. And layer number three, that is network layer. So ultimately, this is the protocol structure of your DECT. Ultimately, DECT protocol structure is divided into two parts. The first part is C-plane, that is control plane. And the second part is U-plane, that is user plane. So ultimately, your user plane that will be having the user interface component and data transfer. And the control plane will having the network data transfer or control information data transfer. So for the C plane, you can have three layers, but for U plane, you are having only two layers. Okay, for C plane, you are having three layers, but for U plane, you are having only two layers. That is physical layer and data link layer. So ultimately, firstly, we will check for the physical layer, what functionality is for C plane and U plane, the physical layer is doing. So ultimately, modulation and demodulation, incoming of signal detection, sending and receiver synchronization, then collection of status information from the management plane. This all work is done by the physical layer, as well as your frames, that is T TDD, after TDD application, you were having 12 slot for uplink and 12 slot for downlink. In the single slot, you can have the specified frame structure. And that frame structure is according to this diagram. Look over here. One frame is approximately having 10 millisecond time. From this 10 millisecond time, we are dividing according to TDMA 12 time slot for uplink and 12 time slot for downlink. From this 12 and 12, that is 24 time slot, if we talk about only single time slot, okay, if we talk about only single time slot, then this single time slot will have the time period of 0.4167 millisecond. Okay, one time slot is having what amount of time? 0.4167 millisecond. From this amount of time, 52 microsecond will be used as guard time. And remaining time will be used for the data transfer format. So from that format, 420 bits will be used. From that format, 420 bits will be used. So this 420 bits, you can say, you can further divide this 420 bits into 32 bits for synchronization purpose and 390 bits for defilled, that is data filled. Okay, synchronization, for synchronization purpose, you are having 32 bits and data filled is having 390 bits. From this 390 bits, we can again further divide the frame structure into A filled, B filled and X filled. The A filled is having 64 bits network control. The X filled is having transmission quality of 4 bit. That means your extra parity bit calculation for error control and detection. And the B filled is having your actual user data. And that will be of 320 bits. Okay, that will be of 320 bits. Now this 320 bits can be transmitted by two way. This 320 bits can be transmitted by two way. First one is protected mode and second one is unprotected mode. In unprotected mode, all the 320 bits will be used for data transfer. Okay, will be used for data storing, you can say, or data transfer. All the 320 bits will be of your actual data. But if we talk about the protected mode, then the protected mode is dividing the 320 bits into data bit and parity bit. So 64 bit will be for data, then after 16 bit will be for parity. Then 64 again for data, then 16 for parity. 64 again data and parity, data and parity. So here you can have only this amount of data bits to be transmitted. So according to this fundamental, the protected mode can have the maximum capacity of 25.6 kbps, but the unprotected mode can have 32 kbps speed. So this was all about the physical layer only from your protocol architecture. Now next one is medium access control layer. The medium access control layer is doing this functionalities, establishing, maintaining and release of channels, then after multiplexing of several logical channel into the physical channel, user data transmission according to your data frame format, then after paging information, then after broadcast messaging, reassembling and segmentation of the packets, error control and detection. This is the basic fundamental or function of your multiple access, medium access control layer. Now, data link layer is adding some of the error control detection functionality and create and maintain the release the mobile terminal and base station data. So ultimately, next layer is network layer. Now look, for network layer, it is basically working for control plane only. For user plane, it is not having any functionality. So the network layer is basically handling the links, that is your logical links. Creation of your link, release of your link, then check, reserve, control and release the resources at your fixed station. All the functionality at the network layer will be done at only C plane. Then after mobility management, obvious, here you are having two type of devices. First one is fixed terminal and second one is portable terminal. So mobility management should be there. And that functioning will be done according to the network layer. Then after call control, because the call should be connected, call should be disconnected according to your receiver, and that setup will be done according to call control in network layer. Then after connection-oriented message service and connectionless message service also being done at the network layer. So this was all about the DECT. DECT, what the DECT is, difference between GSM and DECT. Then after the system architecture of DECT and protocol architecture of DECT. Thank you. We will meet in our next lecture.